What's going on, good people? You listen to the Good Culture Podcast, episode 33. It's your man, Kenny Reeves. I'm sitting here with my partner, T. Lee, and the homegirl, L. Mac. What's going down?
Good morning, good people. It's been an interesting morning.
Damn.
What's happening? Oh, man.
Daylight savings time is kicking my butt today.
What's the point?
Like, I just don't know.
What are we saving for?
I support this.
No, they made this shit up to hold a black man down.
I don't know.
We already can't be on time to stuff.
I felt good when I woke up this morning. I'm like, yes, we got an hour.
Nah, you lost the hour.
I got an hour because now when I get off work, it ain't dark outside and nocturnal animals going to get at my ass on my run. I'm cool.
That's cool. I don't have these problems. I watch the time go from 2 to 3 and got pissed off.
See, I didn't. Wait a minute.
Yeah, I wasn't.
Well, I'm tired, guys.
I kept resetting my alarm this morning. Keenan was up playing the game, and he was just like, "Damn, bro, are you gonna ever wake up?" Respect, my nigga. Respect. I gonna get up.
Nah, I mean, this happens every year. Every year, we act like bitches about it.
I'm fine with it. I'm cool.
Man, look at Kenny's the forward thinker.
Just optimist.
What have you?
Yeah.
I mean, you just wanted to run flaunt us, bro.
Nah, not run flaunt, bro. It's just, y'all know what it's like out there with them coyotes and shit.
That's, you know, you put yourself in a situation because you could easily go to 24 like the rest of us.
I don't like, but see, treadmills hurt my knees. That's a thing when you get past the 25 mark. Shit start hurting that didn't used to hurt.
All right.
True.
Respect.
True.
Yeah.
But it was good.
I don't know. We lived yesterday.
Yeah.
That's part of the reason why we slammed this morning.
Yeah, we washed, bro.
Others are slammed.
The early St. Patrick's Day. You know, I never fooled with St. Patrick's Day before I moved. Honestly, I think last year was the first day I did something for St. Patrick's Day because I always felt like, you know, pinch me. My people was armed by the Irish, so I didn't really, get off into it.
Oh, you know that?
I don't know. I don't know. I think McMillan might be a little Irish thing.
Well, yeah.
I'm sure it does.
Yeah.
You don't get the mix and max and mix.
Well, there you go. That's how you feel about it.
That's how I feel about it.
Yeah.
Nah, I mean, it was dope. I really don't do much for St. Patrick's Day either. But, you know, everybody was living yesterday. City was buzzing about everything. So we got out, enjoyed ourselves.
Yeah.
But shit, it got cold, dog.
It did. I just wanted to wear my green great hat, bro. That's really all I wanted to do. But yeah, we live, and it got cold as shit on us out of nowhere.
Yeah.
But shit was fun, though.
Yeah.
I'm getting to see Turned Up Tea Lee, and it's always entertaining. Like, you know, between Trappiest Hour and. Now you've been on a little day party scene. Like,
he promised us at the beginning of 2017.
He lived up to it.
I wouldn't say you seeing Turned Up T. Lee. You seeing On The Scene T. Lee.
I'm proud of this T. Lee.
That's it. I was really chilling yesterday.
He did.
Yeah.
Everybody kept asking, is he drunk? I'm like, nah, I'm just living.
Yeah.
I don't know. I felt good yesterday for some reason.
Oh, that's what's up. I mean, it was a good day. Shout out to the Black Bunch Brigade.
Mm-hmm.
Shout out to Kev.
Randy.
Randy, everything. It was lit. I will say that. Shout out to the people who won the tickets.
Yeah, shout out to our winners.
Yeah.
It was.
Yeah, we got tickets to Bangers.
Yeah, we got giveaways now in the culture. I'm not sure if y'all knew that. But shout out to our winners yesterday. I will pull them up, but my phone on airplane mode. Yeah. So, big shout out.
Yeah, respect.
And while we touching on Bangers winners, we still got to sling these tickets, fam.
Yeah, I mean.
They moving.
That's what I was just going to say. It's really
up to the
coach. It's up to you to prevent not being in the building.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Like, they moving a lot better than what they've done in the past.
Yeah.
So.
You got the juice now.
It ain't the juice.
I mean, talk your shit, fam. What you mean?
I like to be humble.
Put some respect on the Good Culture name. You got the juice now.
Yeah, we got the juice, fam.
Yeah.
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 We really going for event of the year, man. I've been saying that shit, bro. That's what it is. We trying to boom this motherfucker out, man.
Yeah.
So, gonna get your tickets at www.goodculture.life, Bangers Brunch. But let's get into this culture real quick, man.
We might as well go ahead and discuss a small elephant in the room.
Since
we discussing good culture events, bro.
Go ahead, Lee.
if you were at Trappy, it's Thursday.
Yeah, we gotta do that.
Yeah, we got shut down. Here I am back on the microphone explaining that we've been shut down. But when we say shut down, we don't want people to interpret that as Trappy as our is not a team anymore.
Yeah.
Like, we still going up every Thursday. That's not stopping. Yeah. It was just a situation this past Thursday where crowd was a little sizable, and it was a right place, wrong time type of circumstance.
I don't know. Fire Marshal keep finding his way to Travis, so yeah. I guess they want to live a little bit. But
I don't know why they just can't come in and have a drink.
Yeah, that's what it seemed like. They be wanting to inspect during the time when we going up.
Yeah, they had the John.
Yeah, they had the John, but she not the culture to me, fam.
Yeah.
Oh, wait, what a minute.
It was a black woman.
Oh, black lady shut Trappy's hour down?
She ate it. I don't think she made the call.
She ate it and shutting it down.
Y'all should have just got her a little Hennessy.
I mean, it ain't like efforts weren't tried, you know what I'm saying? But she just wasn't the culture.
Yeah.
But, I mean, Trappy's hour, I will say, has grown and developed into an event that's a staple here in the city. And that's what people come to expect. They came out to have a good time. Sorry that it got shut down, but it's not our fault, but it's our problem.
Listen, man, all good. All this is good.
Yeah.
Like, I'm not sitting here sad about it. I was pissed off about it Thursday night.
I was very pissed.
But I'm not sad about it no more, because that just means, hey, we on a level where people are fucking with the event, people pulling up. So my advice to you is, we're going to do numbers every week.
Talk your shit, T-Lee.
We not going to put it on RSVP on it.
Yeah, just pull up.
Just pull up. Like,
that's what it's been. That was like our most impressive crowd.
Yeah, I don't want to hear, oh, I was hungry, so I went to such and such. Like, we got pizza.
Yeah.
I wanted to, nah, we got drink.
Straight like that.
So get your ass in there.
T-Lee.
Nah.
What?
No, I'm not saying this in a group. It's coming off as aggressive.
I mean, look,
but
bro,
I'm not saying it in an aggressive manner. I'm saying, like,
this is 2017.
This is 2017.
2017. Oh,
come on. Look at him.
Come on.
Let me tell you, 2017. Right. You
the
know,
the dad hats are coming.
Yeah, he out here standing on tables and stuff. Like, I done seen, maybe not last night, but I done seen T-Lee standing on some chairs.
Yeah.
Hitting Southside trying to get somebody attention.
Nah, like, you've changed.
Have I?
You've changed. I mean, why work this hard to stay the same?
I think you're getting a glimpse of who T-Lee really is. It's just a reduced version of it.
This is the responsible dad version of T-Lee.
Okay.
That's it.
I'm proud of him.
I'm finding the balance between the two.
All right, so the moral of the story is, pull up the trappies out. We're going to get the hell shut down again. Like, we're going to turn up. I'm
we
just saying.
We prayed at the motherfucker and shut down.
Well, I mean, I'm not saying, but I'm but just yeah, saying. Like, we're going to do numbers. Same do numbers.
Yeah,
that's a great problem to have. You brought the city out and they shut you down.
It
like,
really
yeah.
is. I got to figure out how to, because I'm a professional. I'm very business savvy and I articulate very well. But when shit doesn't happen in my favor, I just revert to Oak Cliff Kennedy.
Yeah.
So I apologize to anybody that caught me in the aftermath of that. If you heard me say I was going to slide a nigga too, I didn't mean it.
Lord, I said one trappiest hour out. Y'all acting a fool.
Yeah, it really happened.
It's a damn shame.
I was in a pizza place just chopping it up in the top. Hey, let me holler at you, bro. I'm like, for what? They shutting us down, bro. Get the fuck out of here, nigga. And then it was a wrap.
Yeah.
But it's going down this Thursday.
Yeah, I was gonna say, that's that.
Yeah.
You know.
That's it on that.
Yeah. See, we got new music, right?
Yeah. We got some music from Chains, bro.
Yeah.
Smartphone.
Yeah.
Yeah.
How you feel about it? Oh, no.
I mean.
No. No.
I like 2 Chains. Don't get me wrong. But I just don't want to hear about your boy in the pen with the smartphone. This thing got a couple extra years since he got caught with the phone. Like, I don't relate to that. So it wasn't my ministry per se. It wasn't my ministry. And then like I like 2 Chainz. Like 2 Chainz been on this real strong punchline rap thing right now.
He been doing it.
But this song didn't really give me those punchlines either. So I'm just like, I don't know where my voice is, but I'm just like.
It's left on Greenville somewhere.
Yeah.
I think I lost my voice on Thursday. It's been gone. but I just, it wasn't, yeah. I mean, I, you know, I mean, it wasn't bad.
I respect it.
I'm kind of right there with. I'm not right there with Lauren, bro.
I'm not right there with Lauren. Some days I feel like a trap star, like, you know, some days I can do it, some days I don't. This one was the day I didn't. Like, I just didn't, I wasn't rocking with it.
I'm just saying that it's like, it's a song.
Really?
Yeah. Like, it's not somewhere I don't think it's not going to really catch on.
A single.
But it's not something that you, if you riding in it and come on, you're not going to skip it either. It's just a song.
I'm definitely skipping it.
Oh, well, see, that's where me and Lauren's opinion on the song differentiates, because I don't think it's a skip. I think it's just not one where you're not turning up or nothing. It's just like background music.
I fuck with the song 100%.
Yeah, I know.
And I
when we hopped in the car yesterday, that was the first thing playing.
I had it on repeat when I was jogging, not to run, shame or whatever, but I was jogging. It was the only song playing. For an hour and 30 minutes.
Mm-hmm.
So.
Oh, nah. Yeah. I mean, yeah, it's other. It's just, I just feel like.
I just like to hear my nigga voice. He be killing the shit.
Paul.
I mean, no. Play. That's why we like to listen to music. We either like the voice or like what they saying. Shit. I fuck with Chains 100%.
Nah, I mean, like I said, it's solid in my opinion. I'm not down there with Lauren.
I'm not trying to sell it to
Lauren
you,
is being nice about dissing the track.
I mean, I don't. It's not.
She didn't diss it like it was a designer.
Yeah,
joke.
I'm not dissing it. It's not trash. I'm just not. It's not on my playlist. Right. Like, mm-hmm. It's a few new songs got added to the playlist. Like the Rick Ross joint got added. Like, because mm-hmm. I like the sample on
Which
it.
Which one?
I think
track?
She liked me.
Oh,
like,
yeah, no, it was dope.
Yeah,
was dope.
I got a whole samples playlist. So, like, that fits. Like, the 2 Chainz one just didn't do it for me. I like the other joint. The other joint he dropped is cool.
Yeah. Are we being joined? We being joined by the homie Phife.
You're loud ass chirp there. Pulling up.
We just gonna get out there. Damn, bro. What's good, fam?
What's up, man?
Yeah, right.
We can stop buying time.
Yeah. Happy to have you, boss.
What's happening?
Shit, daylight savings got to you?
Man, got to me yesterday.
Nah, I feel it. Turn up king out here.
Shh. I was turned down this morning.
Damn.
And then I got this text. Wake up.
Damn. I saw her. She screenshotted. I don't know if that's snitching or not, but she screenshotted. And I was like, fuck. We was like, shit. Tell him, come on. Finna be a Say Less episode. But nah, go ahead, man. Shit, I guess we go on ahead and get to the Phife interview now.
Yeah, he's here. He's here.
Well, shit, just tell the good people who you are and what you do, man.
I'm DJ Phife. I DJ everywhere, literally everywhere.
Yeah.
Just got back from Colorado for Black Ski Summit.
Damn.
Prior to that, where was that?
Everywhere.
Go back to my calendar. And this weekend coming up, we have that urban cruise weekend going to Mexico. And then Texas Relays, and then I'm going to Paris to kick it.
Damn. Yeah, he really on the road.
Just added that.
He stamp came, your passport.
He came in and talked the shit on the first question.
I'm happy. It's cool. You talk more shit than we talked in 15 minutes. Come through.
But nah, let's talk a little bit about, you know, your background. First of all, are you actually from Dallas?
I'm originally from Wichita, Kansas, and went to high school here. Went to Carter High School.
Woo!
Say less. Lauren. Look at Lauren's face.
Hey, let me
look at Lauren's face.
What?
Y'all finna have a whole Carter reunion off in here.
Man.
When you come out, bro?
2001. Yeah, me and Jay Scott. Jay Scott played for the Bears.
Y'all know Jay Scott. Yeah.
Okay. Yeah.
My cousin came out 02. Chantrese Kennedy.
Sounds familiar.
And Sharonda Pyle.
Okay.
Yeah,
okay.
Ray Pyle.
You know my brother, bro? Charles Lee.
Yeah, I know Charles Lee. Yeah.
That's my older brother, man. Yeah.
Always smiling. Run you over, though.
Yeah.
You playing ball?
Nah, I was an ROTC.
Okay, yeah. Was that Sergeant Sheets?
Yeah.
That was the interview about.
Oh, another interview.
Hey, he from Dallas.
Yeah, that's real Triple D.
Hey, y'all there?
Got H-Town over here like, okay.
I mean, but shit, Carter, bro. You know what I'm saying? That's pride.
We got our own movie.
You know?
Yeah. It might be hood, but we got our own movie.
It's definitely hood.
We was featured in one that did well, too, as the antagonist that stole the show. Right. So, yeah.
Pretty much.
Look at Lauren.
I mean, it's cool.
She hit us with a shrug,
talk
bro.
Talk your shit. I just can't wait to bring somebody on for my alma mater. So, I mean.
if you know about that third parking lot, 1819 West Wheeling Road, you know.
After any club, parking lot. Yeah. Don't care what school you went to. You better know somebody.
Yeah.
But, you know, you can come back there.
Lauren, how you feel? You feel?
I just feel out of place with good people. If honestly, I don't. I'm not familiar.
You went to Carter, fam. Just claim.
Nah, y'all said I was a Townview ass.
She
definitely Townview.
Y'all didn't give me the Carter.
Live in the Carter district with Townview. Caught the bus in the morning. So you knew everybody that went there. You took pictures.
Yeah. Fine. You probably went to Carter homecoming with a nigga that played ball or something.
Had you been in sports, you would have came and played at Carter.
Yeah.
That's fine.
Volleyball.
I was never playing volleyball. That wasn't it. But Phife, let's talk about what inspired you to become a DJ.
Well, when I was younger, I watched Juice, of course, and that's every DJ story. Truthfully, I watched Juice, and then I watched Beat Street, and you know, I was an Ice-T fan, and so I watched the movie, and I was like, "Yo, he's DJing in his room," and I was like, "Man, I want to do that." And so. Yeah. When I used to live in Fort Worth, too, and then there was a record store called Hit City. I used to go up there every Friday. They had a live DJ.
Yeah.
And so I would just go up there and be like, and just stare at it. Yeah. And then I start ordering catalogs. I'm like, yeah, I'm going to circle this. I'm going to buy this. I'm going to get this. I ain't had no job. I'm in seventh grade.
Yeah, yeah.
So it was just a goal, a aspiration. Then I got in high school, and I got some turntables.
Okay.
And just started DJing at the house. And never really took it seriously, went to college, and became a promoter.
Okay.
I went to school in Austin. I started doing parties at Spiro's. And,
I know about Spiro's.
Yeah. Literally all the hottest clubs in Austin I was a part of. And then I just got tired of throwing parties, and I said, I'm going to start DJing.
Yeah.
And I just took it and ran with it.
Okay.
So that's really the story.
So you did it on your own, or did somebody... When was your first gig that you was booked for?
My first gig I was booked for was on campus. I was the on-campus DJ.
Okay.
So we did it. At HT, Houston Tillerson, we had this thing called TGI Fridays. I was a DJ for that. I was a DJ for all the athletic games and everything dealing with student life. I was that DJ.
Then
club-wise, I didn't get a club gig until it was my party.
Okay.
And so I was throwing parties, and I would hire my roommate was a DJ.
Okay.
So I would go up there and say, let me DJ. And so I would do like three or four songs, and he'd come back, save me, do three or four songs.
Yeah.
And then that was cool. That's how I kind of transitioned into it.
Okay.
Then that summer came, and I spent the whole summer trying to find a job.
Okay.
And just DJing.
I know that life.
Between DJing and trying to find a job, I wasn't doing nothing else.
Yeah.
And so I moved back to Dallas in July. Actually, I moved back because I had to watch my nephew for a week. So I got plunked home. My sister went to Essence, and so I was like, I'll watch him.
Yeah.
And... And that week, I got booked at Tafiji's, which is no longer there anymore. It was a jazz club. So I became their DJ. And then Super Bowl came, All-Star came.
Okay.
I had gigs for that. And the rest is history.
That's dope.
And then the MC I work with, he was the first person to book me.
Really?
They did House of Blues.
Okay.
And I got booked for that. And literally, the rest is history. Like, we just kind of, we became the life of the party.
Yeah.
So if you ever come to Wednesday, that's why the chemistry is so real. Like, I've been working with him since I started DJing.
That's
so,
real.
You know.
That's real, bro.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Shout out to Junebug.
Yeah.
Just got married.
Congratulations, fam. So my thing, when I first hear Phife, Phife Dog is what comes to my mind.
Mm-hmm.
What's the inspiration behind your name, though?
My last name is Pfeiffer.
Okay.
You know, it's not a nickname that I picked up. R.I.P. to Phife, but that's not his name.
Yeah.
So it's kind of like when I was younger, they called me Phife. They called my dad Phife.
Mm.
And that was just our name.
Okay.
And
okay. My
friends used to call me C. Phife, but then when I was trying to brand myself, I'm like, C. Phife don't look right.
Yeah.
So I was like, I'm going to drop the C. Phife. It's going to be Phife.
It's lit.
That's kind of how it went. So.
Okay.
It works, though.
Yeah, it really definitely works.
It works.
I thought
it was like profound, like, you know what, growing up, you know, Phife Dawg, Tribe Called Quest, I was really influenced by them.
Hey, let me tell y'all a funny story. When Phife Dawg passed.
Yeah, I remember that. I remember that.
I know where this is going.
I remember. Let me tell y'all this story. Phife Dawg passed. Shout out to Champagne Room. But Brittany called me, and she was like, Lauren... you know, I'm trying to tell you some bad news.
Yeah.
And she said, yeah, you know, her Phife passed, right? And so I had already found out that, you know, it was Tribe Called Quest. And so I'm sitting on the phone, like, she's really, like, trying to figure out how she's going to give me this bad news that DJ Phife has passed. And I'm like, Brittany, she said, yeah, they just dropped it in the group meeting. And nobody said no moment of silence or nothing. Like,
I remember he came in the group and was like, it's not me.
It was so funny. People texting me, asking me if I'm dead. I'm like, how are you texting me?
Like, I'm going to respond. Like,
hey, you dead, fam?
Yeah, I'm out of here.
But no, that's crazy, man.
That just means you got influence. They just, you know, they just saw Phife and they got confused.
I mean, that's true. That's true. A lot of people associate Phife with all the shit that you do. So
what's so funny is his manager, DJ Ross Drew, me and him are real good friends.
Okay.
And Phife was supposed to make me some drops.
Really?
But we never really got around to doing it. And then, of course, he passed away. So I was like, dang.
Damn.
That would have been dope.
It would have
been
dope.
This is Phife supporting my dog, DJ Phife. That just would have been the dopest thing in the world.
Yeah, man.
I'd have used that everywhere. Every hour.
Yeah, real talk, bro.
So I think we should get into the turn up portion of this interview. Let's talk about this new single you got. And we want to know how you and Lil Ronny linked up together and how you made this a thing. So tell us about the song and
so
how the situation came about.
As a DJ, I watch Khaled, I watch Drama, I watch all of them. Me and Don Cannon are real good friends. So basically what happened, I put out a mixtape called It's Lit.
Okay.
And Don Cannon just so happened to be in town the same week. I said, yo, man, this is my new mix or whatever. Da, da, da. He said, oh, this your single? I'm like, nah, it's my mixtape.
Right.
He said, oh, man, you need to drop a single.
Okay.
I'm like, for real? I'm like, okay, cool. So me and Super, we were already having a working relationship.
Okay.
Like him along with every other artist in the city, shout out to everybody.
Right.
They would come through, try to give me that music to get it played at Gators, and he was the only one that really took it serious, the only one that really, really followed up. I was like, man, let's really do something. Like, I mean, I see you receptive to the songs that I'm bringing, what can I do to get something that's going to pop? I said, well, let's do a song together.
Yeah.
And so we went through like two or three different songs and tried to put another song together, and it just didn't work out. Like, we had his verse, and we were missing a verse. And so it's like, okay, cool. Well, I got this other record with Lil Ronny.
Yeah.
I was like, okay, cool, let me hear it. And so when I first heard it, I didn't like it.
Really?
I was like, yeah, I don't know.
Really?
And then once he laid it all the way out, like, because I heard his verse, I didn't hear Ronnie's verse first. And then when he put it together, this is when I went to Virgin Islands. I listened to it the whole time on the plane. I was like, yo, this is it.
Yeah,
this is it. And so I was like, okay, cool. Well, what are we going to do? So we sat down, we planned it out, how we're going to roll the song out. We was like, well, let's do it at Gators.
Yeah.
And so, of course, Gators was like the perfect platform to release it. And then, you know, everybody kind of got behind it. And it's your jams.
Yeah, really.
Yeah. So, yeah. But now I'm talking with E1 Music and a few people at Def Jam. So we're working on some things right now. But we'll see.
That's dope, bro. I mean, the song really is one of the songs right now in the city.
Yeah.
I'm caught in some promo for Wings Day. Dancing to the song. So,
yeah, you definitely are.
I mean, I fuck with it. Shit, I'm behind the song. Shit, I don't know.
But believe it or not, I'm working on the EP, so I have two other songs that are complete, and I'm looking for like two more right now. So
I
got some beats that I'm putting together with some artists, and we're just really working now. So.
That's real, bro.
You gonna let me get on the tape, Phife?
Come on now, you know.
Yeah, I'm gonna spit, you know, quick 16.
I got you. You know what? I got a skit for you. I'll play Mo City Don in the background, and I'll just let you have at it.
I appreciate it. It's fine. Y'all making jokes.
Made Houston feel good about
have
this.
Have y'all seen her when Mo City Don come on?
Yeah.
She's not even Lauren anymore.
They are very disrespectful putting this shit in people's face.
Listen,
you know?
Mo City Don is, that's my hood. Like,
that's like Oak Cliff, that's my hood.
It's the thing. Like, I went to school in Missouri City, Thurgood Marshall 2234. Like, that's where we out here. Yeah. So
I can respect it.
I can relate.
I definitely respect it.
Yeah. I watch Oak Cliff, that's my hood, come together.
Yeah, we
started at Carter. Right. You know what I mean?
We're gonna get them all on the show though, so we can have a whole Marshall moment. I can't wait to bring
You gonna bring Travis Scott to this motherfucker?
Travis didn't go to Marshall. Travis went to Elkins, you know, he went to the other school.
That's the only way I want them all on the show.
That's like Carter Kimball.
We got some fire out the mall. Now a lot of us might not have went nowhere, but the few that did, we did a little
thing. Houston Music, Screw Music, Swisher House, Bellway, they had the biggest influence on Texas to
really
date.
Did. Yeah, like, yeah.
I still play Kappa music, Kappa party, yeah. Beach, Kappa yeah. Beach party music.
Before the Kappa 2, Kappa. Yeah.
Drag 50, 50 him in my cup.
Twin. Yeah. Yeah.
Actually, he has a new song out with my boy, I can't talk. DJ Goldie, he's got a song out called I'm Rich or whatever. So they got some stuff going out too. So.
I didn't even know 50-50 was still rapping.
Definitely still rapping. That's real. He's dope too.
I mean, I'm glad you said that because coming up, all we did was listen to Swisher House and all that shit.
Yeah.
I didn't know Houston niggas didn't like us till we got to college.
I'm letting y'all know that it's not the beef that Dallas has with Houston. Houston don't really care.
Damn, I don't know why.
At the school I went to, they definitely care. Oh, it's that Dallas nigga.
Oh, yeah. Dallas ass nigga. Leather hat ass nigga.
I think anytime they got to travel north,
they come with the Anna.
Honestly, I never knew that it was Dallas-Houston beef until I moved to Dallas. Like, I was like, oh, they don't like us? Like, I didn't know. Because, like, where I went to school, we was just happy to see some other black people. So, we really care.
35 minutes up the road, and then them Houston niggas did not like us.
It was like that until Hurricane Katrina, believe it or not, and then Louisiana came, and it was just like Texas versus Louisiana every weekend.
that was a bad time.
And then that's when Dallas and Houston was like, yeah, man, we cool. Because they took over our cities.
Yeah.
Not like that, but you know.
I can't say they took over.
Yeah.
No, they definitely didn't take over. They made the news.
It was a time.
They definitely made the news.
Let me say this.
Say a lot less. Because we was in the hallways with them people. But say a lot less. But
y'all was fighting in Carter?
Hey,
I'm saying less.
Next
time. I'm saying less.
I mean,
Leslie Williams ain't finna come after me.
It was Miss Wiggum. She was the principal at the time.
Yeah, I was there with Leslie Williams.
Yeah.
Post Mr. Brew comes Leslie Williams. Yeah.
Shout out to Mr. Brew and his daughters.
Come on, bro. They both married now. Right?
I don't know.
Very doing very well too.
Very pretty young lady.
Yeah. Shout out to them. Go ahead. Keep going. Go on.
Plug.
Go on.
Interview question number 7.
Yeah. I'll say, good people, I'm sorry y'all didn't go to Carter and y'all just as lost as I am. Who are these people?
Look at them. Shit. They fine.
But, all right. Next question.
Interview question number 7. Just looking over the landscape of Dallas, bro. It's not a lot of parties that you don't see Phife on. How does it feel to know that whenever somebody wants to do something here domestically, that they're reaching out to you?
It's an honor, man, because when I first started, I couldn't catch a break.
Really?
So I just kind of stayed working with who I was working with, and they finally took over.
Right.
You know what I mean? Things changed, and a lot of people moved up and elevated their game, and so they traveled too.
That's dope.
And so it just kind of opened the door for me. So I'm grateful.
Yeah.
Like, I really appreciate it.
Like, you the man. Like, a lot of, like, Phife here?
Yeah.
Phife here? Okay, man.
Man, you know? Like, if I'm not there, like, if I'm not DJing and I walk into the club, hey, man, why you not DJing? I'm
right.
Like, oh, I can't kick it.
Yeah, pretty much. I see you in the back of Travis. I was just ducked out from the back.
Oh, man, I'm trying to chill.
I come
like,
to
Vue's my boy, so I'm like, yeah, I'm going to hear Vue DJ.
Yeah.
DJ my birthday party, so, you know, I got to go support.
Yeah,
so.
Shout out to Vue.
Yeah.
If he ever move here, it's over, y'all.
Yeah, we just trying to get Stevie down 35. Like,
I want to get him a job at SMU or something.
I just was like, you know, and I'm trying to be respectful. I'm like, bro, you know, I really want to book you in April, but I know you finna have this kid. So.
Exactly.
So, I don't want your wife to cuss me out. Shout out to Ariel. Like, I don't want any beef.
This text line we got.
So I see you trying to be, you know, humble. But we hear you going international, man. So let's talk about that a little bit. You can choose to be humble about it, or you can talk your shit. But,
talk your shit, man.
But let's talk about it a little bit.
Well, when I started, when I was a promoter, I wanted to do, like, Maxim parties. I wanted to do Playboy-type parties. I wanted to do big stuff. Like,
right.
I didn't want to just be, oh, I'm the guy in Austin. Like, I was like, okay, cool. I want to go somewhere they know who I am.
Right.
And so, like, with the DJing thing, I have a lot of friends from college and from different events that I've done, and they are really popping.
Right.
So, like, when I did TIAA, the promoters that booked me, they say, hey, man, we finna go. So-and-so gonna handle, they gonna pay you. We going to Floyd Mayweather's party.
Okay.
And so those are the people that booked me for the Wale party in Vegas.
Okay.
And so it's the network that I've always had. They're doing bigger stuff. So I was like, okay, cool. This is my platform to do what I want to do.
Right.
So on top of that, like when I went to Bangkok, I just did some networking and I got booked. So it's just like wherever I go, I'm trying to get booked.
I hear that. Just kind of that's Thailand just, for y'all that don't know your geography. That's like whole different culture.
Your passport.
Yeah. Yeah.
Yo, and if you black, go to Thailand.
Really?
Don't let nobody tell you that, you know, black people are inferior. When you leave United States, they treat us like gods.
Damn.
Like, I couldn't even walk down the street. I feel like I was one of the Beatles. They grabbing me like, hey, chocolate man, it's a black guy. You know what it is? Yeah. Here, they try to cross the street on you, grab their purse. Yeah, but, you know, in other countries, man, they love us.
That's real.
They love us, so.
Man.
I encourage all my brothers to travel.
I need to travel.
Real quick.
Get my paper up first.
Him saying that made me think about the other night when we was standing out talking and the guy was walking his dog.
Yeah, and that nigga.
He acted like, don't touch my dog.
So a Thai, he pet the dog.
Yeah.
He acted like a Thai gave the dog a disease or something. Like the dog was too good for a Thai.
Man,
and like
on.
Was literally like tugging,
tugging
at the leash,
his dog
like,
away from
come
him.
On. And I was just like, wow, that just brought that to my mind. Yeah. That was I'm all off topic shit. Go ahead, Lord.
Hey, that's still on topic though.
Yeah.
Because when you leave the country, you'll see that doesn't exist.
Mm-hmm.
They're like, this. They praising you. So
okay,
it's a real good thing.
That's what's up.
That's a dope perspective.
And see, that's gonna help him going international. Or whatever, you know what I'm saying? Like, that's what's up.
Yeah.
Yes. So you run in the city of Dallas. We already established that. Phife Show is international. Like, are there any like markets that you just want to be like where you know where you want to be popping domestically or internationally where people know your name in the city?
Believe it or not, I'm not popping in Houston. Like, I'm not popping in Houston. Like, Houston, I love Houston. I will go down there more, but man, like, I don't have no juice in Houston. Like, those are my people down there. I fuck with everybody, but I mean, it's just kind of not, that's the only city that. Houston is, and I'm not popping to Houston.
Let's go get some juice in Houston then, fam.
Yeah, Lori.
Yeah. Wait, this is on me, all right?
No, I catch a few gigs in Houston, but I'm not popping to Houston like I want to be.
Right.
I think with the DJs that are in Houston that are from Dallas, Mr. Rogers, High C, it would be a real good thing to be able to link up with them and do bigger stuff.
Right.
Because they kind of run that market, and I do my thing in this market,
right,
so it would
right.
be good to collab in their market as they come here, too.
Right.
So that's what I envision. And in Atlanta, too. I mean, you got to do Atlanta.
Yeah.
Atlanta is the must-have right now.
I fuck with Atlanta.
Yeah.
So just speaking about Atlanta real quick, they have a solidified front in Atlanta with the way their DJs support the Atlanta music, and they push that to the forefront.
Mm-hmm.
So I knew I wanted to ask you this question, man, because I was on Instagram a couple of days ago and saw the homie Mel from Outfit Texas.
Mm-hmm.
He gave like a three-part PSA about how Dallas DJs are like the historians or the gatekeepers of the music.
Mm-hmm.
And how here lately, he hasn't been hearing a lot of music from that boogie area, that boogie era, or the new music in Dallas that's coming forward. And I was going to ask you, do you think that Dallas DJs are responsible to getting that music out to the people in the city?
Believe it or not, it goes hand in hand. It's like, the artists have to do more than just bring their music to the DJs because, we're the gatekeepers for the nightlife, but in the nightclub, people want to hear what they already know.
That's true.
And so I use Bryson Tiller, for example. He's from, Kentucky, right?
Yeah.
What DJs is in Kentucky that you know that's really popping? How we hear about Bryson Tiller?
From the
internet.
Market. Yeah.
You know, so Drake, same thing. Internet. He's from Canada. How you going to get Canada music down here?
Right.
Internet. So a lot of the artists here, they stop at the DJs and like, hey, man, the DJ not fucking with me. Man, look, the internet is free.
Yeah.
And I learned this by pushing my own song. I haven't called a DJ. I haven't took my music to a DJ. Like, they just naturally support it because I'm grinding my ass off.
Right.
Like, my first step was I took the blogs by storm. I put it on different internet radio sites. I posted it wherever I could where they allowed me to before they kicked me off.
Mm.
And after that, I just played it myself.
Yeah.
You know, I build my own platforms and play my own music.
Right.
Artists, they just got to put out more work. Like, you just got to work harder. You know, it's just like getting a job interview. Like, you just going to keep going to the same job. And they say, we're going to call you back.
Yeah, you got
to. You're going to keep going.
A lot of times you do have to go ahead and make some of their own success for yourself. Like you say, I think it goes hand in hand where it got to have something to where it can travel to where you play it to where the people can fuck with it at the same time.
But a lot of times they don't realize that their music has to have legs first, and they got to create that movement themselves.
Right.
Mm-hmm.
And so, because the DJ can't do nothing like on that scale, unless y'all have a partnership.
Right.
But I mean, as an artist, you gotta get your music popping, and it's not just in the clubs where you get your music popping.
That's true.
Because I mean, you sit at the computer all day.
Right, right.
You listen to music on the computer. Like a lot of people listen to Spotify. A lot of people on SoundCloud. A lot of people be wherever they get music from. But you gotta find that out.
And everything. It's not a club record, too.
Not at all.
Do y'all think that Dallas is, like, comparatively, living in Houston and living here, like, I think Dallas, like, Dallas puts on for Dallas. Like, I feel like it's harder to be an artist out of another, well, maybe not another city, but, like, compared to Houston, like, I feel like Dallas rocks with Dallas music. Like, I've been to more, like, underground shows and seen more artists come out of Dallas that people actually, like, they can go and sell out a show at Trees and go and sell out a show, you know, at Southside or something like that. Like, I don't see, you don't necessarily see that in Houston.
I think, oh, you was going in?
No, go ahead.
No, I think it's about just, we know in Dallas who's dope in Dallas. I think the problem is a lot of these artists want to break outside of Dallas and they feel like the city ain't all the way behind them and taking them outside of the market.
Mm-hmm. I can speak on that as a DJ, like, before I was popping in Dallas, I was popping somewhere else.
That's true, too.
I left Dallas to go get popping in Austin and D.C. and Miami, and then I came back. It's like, oh, he doing all this and this and that and that and that. So, I mean, you got to leave home to get popping at home.
I think people take pride in knowing that you from Dallas once you go somewhere else, and then when you bring it back home.
DeRozan's prime example, when he put an ice cream paint job, he didn't get popping in Texas first. Right. He left and came back when it was popping.
Right.
But you got to, just like an artist, when they got a hot mixtape or they got a hot album, they go on tour. Yeah. And they go get their money and then they come back home.
Yeah, I like
you know, it's the same thing.
Yeah.
But a lot of people just, if you have a map of success, I mean, it's gotta be in there. Like if you don't have no map, you just kinda like, well, they're not fucking with me, so I don't know what to do.
Right.
And I'm frustrated. And I mean, they made a diss song about me, but that didn't stop me. Artist made a diss song, said he was gonna slam my laptop, said he was gonna do this, said I got him banned from a club. I'm like, man, come on, bro.
Damn.
But I talk to him every day on the phone. Like, we email each other, but I did all this.
Really?
But, yeah.
That's a lie. I don't know if I could have a diss record about me, bro.
I just kept it moving.
Yeah, I mean,
they love you and they hate you, then they love you again.
Yeah. Yeah.
My quick 2 cents on it is just, I think Dallas doesn't have necessarily that standout artist, where it's like there's levels in it in the city, but there's not that one artist that's like internationally known or somebody like in Houston. Like Travis Scott is gonna sell out a show.
What about Erykah Badu?
I was speaking specifically to rap.
Okay.
Yeah. No disrespect to Badu. Mm-hmm. But I was just speaking specifically to rap. We don't have like an artist that necessarily stands out above everyone else in the city, to where I think Houston does have that.
Okay.
Where they name sort of ring out, so they may push their shows a little bit harder in Houston, and it might be a bigger deal, to where it's here, everybody trying to eat, and everybody showing love for everybody, because everybody's still trying to reach a certain level.
I'm saying more so like people who haven't like made it on the international level can sell out a show here still. So, like, in Houston, you got to be a Travis Scott to sell out a show.
Yeah.
You got to be a Travis Scott. Like, you can't necessarily be, you know, an underground success and sell out shows here. Phife just don't know. We on YouTube. Like, we
can I put on for my Snapchat?
No,
yeah.
Good
people.
I just put a character like a bitch.
He waving it.
We out here freestyling, y'all. Blame the time change. Yeah. Just apologize to y'all in advance.
But nah, I mean, back to your point.
But I'm saying, that's what I'm saying. Like, I think it's harder in, I will say Dallas, I've noticed that about Dallas music. Like, I've gone to shows and I'm like, I don't know none of these people, but it's packed in here.
We be having like a...
Or even I think Dallas will show love to artists that's not on. Like, I remember going to see Kendrick here in 2009 with the Misfits, like years ago. And like, people didn't wasn't rocking with Kendrick then, but like, Dallas showed Kendrick love. I went here to the show and then I went to Oklahoma City in the show and it was the crowd. You know, the crowd is totally different. So I think Dallas is responsible for like a lot of talent gets, you know, legs here.
We got like a little brother complex to Houston, almost.
We always will.
We do.
I mean, Houston, they got Scarface, they got Rap-A-Lot, they put out so many hits.
Yeah,
and they had their own movement. Right. You know, that's when you leave Texas, man, y'all got that screw music. Yeah. Man, we ain't really listening to screw like that no more, but that's what people think.
Yeah.
So I'm like, yeah, we do.
Right. We see Houston had it first and they had their wave, and then we had a moment in the spotlight. It just, ours was quick. It was like, they was here, they danced, and then they went on back.
Yeah.
So
yeah.
It's about getting it back. I'm super pro Dallas, bro. Yeah. I want Dallas to rise to the top, man. So
Phife, what's next for you? I mean, we know you going international, like, what should we expect? You told us about the EP. What's you know, in the next year, what should we be looking for from DJ Phife?
Next year. More traveling, and shoot. That's a tough one. That's a year. A lot can happen in a month. I don't know. Trying to get on radio, believe it or not. Okay. So that's a big goal.
We got you on the Good Culture Podcast. You already out here.
We out you, me. So yeah, that's always been a goal of mine, to get on radio, whether it be 97.9 K104. Hey, look me up.
Yeah.
I feel like you got that though. Yeah. I feel like that's something that you'll be able to achieve like real easy.
Yeah.
It's just connecting them dots, man. That's it. So
I fuck with it.
Really what you should do is just let the diss record, you know, drop. And that's gonna get you hype in the streets. I mean
heard this diss record, bro.
You know, diss records is out here reviving people's careers. So like, you know, somebody drop a diss.
We talking about reminisce last week.
Segway.
Yeah.
Segway.
Why are we talking diss records? Have you heard the No Fraud joint?
Yeah.
What's your thoughts on it?
It's cool.
Yeah.
It's to me, it's not a diss record. It's a song. Yeah, it was their next song, right. And they rewrote Nicki's verse to make it a clapback at Remy Ma.
Damn.
So, emphasis on they.
He said they twice.
Yeah. I mean, you can, if you know the music, you can listen to, like, okay,
it sounded like a Drake flow on that joint. It sounded like a Drake flow. She was spazzing like Drake a little bit.
So, but, you know.
Yeah, I mean.
Go ahead.
This beef really is washed now. Like, I was really excited for it. But,
and you know what?
I mean, I will say it's a smart move on Nicki, like, I'm gonna drop a single too. Forget a diss record. I'm gonna drop a single, so I'm not gonna make some money off of. It's a smart move, but I'm really for it. You know, the thing about calling in No Frauds, like,
I mean, that's tough.
That was like, it's like, you know, I saw a meme that said, and I hate to come for Drake right now, but
this all has shit to do with Drake. Let's move on. Like, for real. So,
but I'm just saying, like, you know, it ain't really a lot of real about the people that's saying, man. It's like, you know, they said Drake wanna be Houston, Caribbean, you know, whatever, like, what
he's
saying?
Definitely the six. He's all six boroughs in one. Just depend on what song you listen to.
So I'm just saying, like,
you too, bro. You came here with the Drake hate, bro.
You know what? This is my thing, and I don't like how everybody got on Drake's side on this disc. I'm like, he.
You talking
if
about
you
the,
diss
on the Meek,
somebody
on the Meek joint? On the Meek disc?
I come from Cannabis and LL Cool J. Okay. I come from
Jay-Z, Nas,
Tupac versus the world, all that. Now you look at the disses that are recent, they not saying nobody names. Mm-mm. They not really super disrespectful until Remy Ma came out.
Remy Ma had the hardest diss.
But then
she put out another one.
That
joint.
Yeah, she shouldn't have put out another one, then we would have been cool.
I think what Drake did to what Nicki's doing, he did the back-to-back. So back to what you were saying, it really wasn't a diss, it was a record. But he said he wanted something that was going to keep hitting him. You go to the club, you get a bottle, you got to hear me talk shit about you.
I mean, and that's fine.
He did that, but Nicki didn't do it.
I said, I think it was a power play to put out a song that can be a single that's going to get radio play. Like, it's smart. And now, whether or not it was the hardest moment for hip-hop, it wasn't. So, it's just one of those things, like, and I just think it's crazy that they called it No Frauds. Like,
you keep on the Drake chain.
But no, I'm not even, it's just like Remy Ma talked about Nicki's whole life being fake.
Yeah.
And then you call your song No Frauds. Like, you really kind of played into it, but like, it's like, you can't really address it because Remy Ma shot herself in the leg, like we talked about.
She tried to bob the joint. But
yeah, definitely
the beef is over.
It's done.
Remy don't need to try to come back with anything. And I'm right there with y'all. Nicki made the business play.
Yeah.
She didn't make the play for the streets. She didn't make the play for the disc culture in rap. Yeah.
But if you're not from the streets, you don't really know the code. So it's kind of like, oh, we're going to make a diss song back. Yeah. But we're going to make it a song and make it a business.
Yeah, I mean, I just feel like on some MC shit, she should have, like, wrote a joint.
She should have.
I don't think she had enough.
No, she didn't, because even in the verse, she had like three facts or
Remy
went
got Nicki life story.
I don't know. Like, I'm just kind of disappointed in Nicki. I already felt the way. I was like, you know, you do all this. Lil' Kim has said you out here trying to be her blueprint. You go to Paris dressed like Lil' Kim. Like, I don't know. So the fact that they called it No Frauds just kind of rubbed me the wrong way.
I mean, all I really wanted Nicki to do was to respond. Mm-hmm. You know what I'm saying? Like, that just closed the book on that beef.
Yeah.
So if Remy ain't got much more.
Yeah, if Remy come out with something else now, it's just like, all right, go home, Roger.
No, but then you're gonna see mm-hmm. that she's trying to revive her career through mm-hmm. poking at Nicki Minaj.
But you know, that's what Nicki said. Nicki said, I want you to get a booking interview without having to say my name, and I want you
what
to.
What you said, she gonna give $500,000?
And I'll give you $500,000 if you can make a hit record.
See,
yeah, I mean, the best information I got out of this is that Hov is still giving people verses, so that gives me hope for an album. So that's the best information I got.
Yeah, I just feel like, yeah, just keep making good music. So when Rick Ross and 50 Cent were beefing, Rick Ross was taking shot at the shot.
But Ross went hard, though.
Ross kept putting out real good music. Yeah. So it was like, okay, cool, that doesn't even matter.
Yeah, he went over the top of that Waka Flocka joint. I remember that. Yeah, it was dope.
While we on beef, though, you mentioned earlier that y'all were in CIAA. Yeah. So mm-hmm. we happen to know that y'all was there for the whole
Young Dolph shootout.
100 rounds.
Yeah. I was DJing my ass off. And the promoter comes with, hey man, cut the music up some. They outside shooting. I'm like,
oh, he just told you to cut it up?
Yes.
Damn.
I was like, okay, cool. How am I going to get out of here? I didn't bring my equipment, so I just got my laptop. I'm going to grab my bag. I'm going to go this way, and I'm going to cut up the street. Yeah, I had an escape plan and everything.
Yeah.
Damn. So did y'all hear 100 rounds?
I didn't hear anything. I was
okay.
DJing.
Okay.
So.
Listen, my whole Charlotte experience, I've been to Charlotte before, but never out in Charlotte. So I just was kind of taken aback that it's like country hood. And so it's a weird dynamic. Like you would think like people outside of Texas probably like, you know, Dallas is probably country hood, but no, it's not. These
country hood like Memphis shit.
Yeah.
Memphis and,
like they for real country hood. Like I hadn't heard highs in years. I was like, they still got highs? Like, I can hear your music outside your car and it's no bass. Just
that speaker in the grid and the bumper.
Yeah. Yeah.
I didn't know that was still a thing. Like, I ain't heard that since, you know, 2000. So I didn't hear no shots, but I think it's a power play from Young Dolph. You drop a mixtape called Bulletproof.
Yeah, stemming from that. Yeah.
The track list is 100 shot. Like, he's talking all of his shit.
See,
so
this is my theory on it. I hate to be this guy, and I hate to say this shit on wax, but this is how I feel.
Go ahead.
Somebody gonna die, bro. I'm not projecting that on hip-hop. I don't want anybody to die, but niggas going at each other this hard and then actually shooting and all this crazy shit, somebody's gonna die in this beef, bro.
Yeah, that's just...
And it's not East Coast, West Coast. You niggas are in the same city.
Right.
Same city.
And it's not as big as Dallas. Y'all in the same little ass
city. Dallas, Fort Worth.
Yeah. So, that's gonna be bad.
You know, I told you that when he dropped Play With Your Bitch.
Yeah, did you see the video?
No.
Man. You ain't seen the video?
No,
I heard that it's a nigga that looked like you.
Just like him. Same head shape, everything.
No,
it's bad.
Like,
I'm like, man, I want to shoot him.
Yeah.
All jokes aside, if I'm your guy, hey, man, I'm going to go find this dude. I'm going to shoot him for real.
If you send 100 shots, it's bad. You ain't hit 100 shots.
But, I mean,
I'm not going to theorize on how the man can actually die, but this is tough. This is a lot, bro. This is a lot for hip-hop.
I don't want either one of them. Like, Memphis, this is my thing. To Memphis, don't encourage this. Y'all need both of them.
Yeah. Man, it's a balance. Yeah. It's a real good balance.
Where's Juicy J
right
at? Like,
making weed music?
Juicy J is popping. Still.
You gotta
say
come
no
be
to
the
Ratchet
mediator.
Pussy. Juicy J can't.
You gotta get 3-6 Mafia to
pull out
there.
Yeah, Project Pat gotta sit them down.
They gotta put the Oscar on the table. Like, look, bro, it's a bigger picture here.
Exactly.
Yeah.
Right.
Shit, even the blues legends. You know what I'm saying? Just let them
Everybody
know.
On Beale Street. If you a legend on Beale Street, just talk to him.
They got to bring Terrence Howard in there one time. Just
hey, man, come on, man. Y'all really going to shoot it out there, man.
Y'all fucking up my mode, man.
Y'all fucking up my mode, man. But y'all just gonna be beefed out like that, man.
But while we talking beef, you know, again, Dallas Homer and me, I have a little beef with Henapalooza skipping over the D, bro. Now this is the second time.
But you know what? We could just create our own. Yeah. That's it. That's always my response. If they're not booking you, man, just make your own.
That's real. So same way with trap karaoke. I'm trying to be patient with them niggas.
Just create your own. I mean, you got trap his hour.
Yeah. Salute, bro.
You know,
I'm trying not to push that button.
Push the button, bro.
I'm trying not to push the button.
Why y'all keep skipping over Dallas?
This is exactly because we got to put our own stuff out. We can't expect somebody to come bring us something.
Yeah. That's true.
We got to go get it ourselves.
That's real. I mean, in theory though, Hennypalooza in Houston. I mean, I saw the pictures from it was last night in Houston. It looked lit, but I've been in Houston and I've been in other cities. And it definitely, like, it was not the same Hennypalooza. So I don't really think that we're missing out on nothing.
We have Hennypalooza every Wednesday. every time me, Lauren, and E. Grayson do a day party, it's Hennypalooza.
Say less.
Or Crown Palooza, whatever you want to call it. Our birthday party?
Stupid.
I don't even want to talk about it.
Yeah.
Lauren, do you remember?
Hey, I mean, it went up. I can tell you that.
Shout out to DJ View.
Yeah, it went up. I walked in and I was like, "Fife, it's your birthday. Get off the." I was like, "View can handle this. You know this, right?"
Yeah, he really can.
He was like, "Yeah." He was like, "Man, I don't know why I was up there, DJ." I was like, "Enjoy yourself, man."
You were DJing your own joint, bro.
I wanted to. This is my little set. Yeah. And if you go come and
I got there, it was like 12.
She bossed me out the DJ booth. Don't listen to her.
I was like, "View got it. Like, just trust in my boy. Like, he got it."
We had already talked.
Yeah.
It was already okay. I'm gonna do from this time to this time, and then you got it.
Yeah. Yeah.
I just wanted DJ.
Well, that's dope.
Nah, man. Hennypalooza skipping Dallas. You know me. I'm right there with Phife on it. If they feel like they don't want to show the city love, we go love the city ourselves.
We got our own shit here that can travel and go other places. Yeah. Like we talk to Bangers and Brunch.
Yeah. Let's do it.
Yeah.
Let's do it.
We reaching say less levels at this shit, bro.
Let's do it.
I mean, I'm
Grits and Biscuits came and did Wednesday at House of Blues. Yeah. Like, let's do our own. Like, yeah. I don't like when other people come to our town and take what we do and make it bigger.
Yeah.
And we don't have nothing to do with it. I didn't get no ticket for it.
I went to it. I wouldn't necessarily say that they did.
Compare that to Wednesday.
Yeah.
Compare it to Wednesday.
Well, I said it was a dud.
So if we put our own production team together and did our own,
it'll go up a lot.
All the way up.
Yeah.
We're reaching say less levels.
I'm saying
say less, I'm not meaning like we're not going to say anything. I'm saying
we'll
fucking get it done.
Yeah. Push the button.
Yeah. Yeah.
All right, there it is. Say less. Let's do some positive things for the country. We've been talking about beefs and, you know, bulletproof and 100 shots. Like, we got to shout out. We missed the opportunity to shout out Chano giving $1 million to the city of the Chi.
Let's give a round of applause for that real quick.
It's lit. Yeah, it's lit for the culture.
I would love to do that for DISD one day.
Yeah.
But
where they going to put the money?
At Carter High School. I'm 1819 West Wheatland.
Did they ever fix the tiles that fall off the ceiling?
They fixed it.
We had mirror tin windows.
They fixed that too. They fixed that. And the cafeteria is
dope. Yeah. I seen that.
But you know what I heard? The only reason they fixed the mirror tin windows is because drivers on 20 were complaining that it was reflecting.
Wait. So the windows had tin on them?
Yes. Mirror tinted windows.
Yeah.
Why?
I thought that shit was cool.
Hey, we have a school with no windows.
Yeah.
It's a school with no windows. That's the feeder middle school. The feeder middle school, when you get to high school, you got mirror tint.
Yeah. That's some real Dallas shit.
I've gotten a lot of Dallas information today.
Yeah.
We got to also shout out, you know, Texas born bred Michael Bennett is giving all his endorsement money to black youth now. Like, people out here doing major moves for the culture.
I fuck with the Bennett brothers.
Marty came through Quill last week. Like, mm-hmm. like they out here, and he just got traded, and I just feel like
to the Packers.
But honestly, I feel like they pushed him out because he didn't go to the White House. Like,
I don't think his contract was up, so yeah. You know, yeah, but, that's how they're gonna spin it. But.
Yeah, but I just feel like, you know, people make strides for the culture, and you know, it gets a little rocky. So everybody who's standing up,
Tom Brady didn't bring his ass to the White House anytime he won a Super Bowl during Barack Obama.
Well, we'll see. And you know, when Colin Kaepernick is like, "Yo, we'll sign you, but you can't have this platform anymore." Right. That's what they told him. So
yeah. Back to the Niners or where?
This is any team, like, because you know, free agent. So it's like,
but you know, he said he's gonna stand up now.
Yeah.
And then ESPN took it and ran.
The check is real.
Yeah.
The check is real.
But I mean.
But this is the positive segment.
This is the positive segment. So shout out to Chance, man. Education is important, especially in 2017, especially with the president we have in office right now. Like, we need to. Education is empowerment.
Yeah.
And
especially who run the Department of Education. That motherfucker don't know that. Yeah.
So
homeschool, you know, self-taught.
Any bit helps, but a sizable amount like Chance gave to the students of Chicago, knowing the efforts that need to be put into, you know, saving children, literally, in Chicago.
And actually
that's
doing,
major.
Yeah, putting it back in your hometown, putting it back in your city.
That's dope. Like, if I had $1 million to give away, sorry, Houston, but I have to give it to the D. I have to give it to Detroit because they need it more.
Yeah, Detroit and Chicago are like
just
really
give
bad.
It to the city of Detroit.
No.
You have to appropriate it yourself.
Talk about somewhere you got to say, this is where the money's going.
I want to know, how did a city go broke?
Listen.
How did they file misappropriation
of funds? I love my people. I do. But when you give black people in general too much power, like, it just was a lot of corruption. It was a lot of people like they was just big kicking it. Like, Kwame was out here just wilding. Like, they got hoes coming to the mayor's mansion and stuff. Like, him and what's his name? The judge, Greg Mathis, just out here kicking.
I know,
like,
your stuff.
Greg Mathis was in the shit.
I know you smoke crack.
Who you gonna call to bring us some up? Yeah. Let's get the best.
Honestly, like, I'm glad that this, like, to put my Detroit hat on, because I don't really, I it's rare that I'm always arguing with y'all about Houston. Put my Detroit hat on, though.
Please.
Like, Houston, Detroit had a really long history. Like, we was one of the first cities to have a black mayor. Coleman Young was mayor of Detroit for almost 20 years. Like, so it was a really strong legacy to fuck up. So. Yeah. I'm just excited to see. It's a lot of new development going on, and I really like, I meet people from Detroit in Dallas almost every day, and so I really wish it was a revival where people were going back to the city and those young people were staying out there. I'm not moving back.
Is there any reason for us to want to travel to Detroit?
I mean, Detroit is lit. I mean, we can go and have a good time. I'll show y'all a good time. I can get my grandparents out there on the barbecue. We go to the casino. We go on the riverfront.
What's the place with the good ass wings?
Everywhere. It's a lot of good food in Detroit.
Shout out to my homie Kenny Valentino in Detroit.
Okay.
He's radio MC up. That's my boy. They play my song on the radio up there.
Oh, that's
good. I love Detroit.
Let's tell us how to do a Wings Day in Detroit. I heard you say Wings. Y'all
let's go.
Yeah, I mean, we can get it popping. I mean, I'll take y'all through the 313.
I mean, I ain't took
my hood pass yet. I ain't been gone that long.
I want to see. I didn't put it on the list of cities to travel, but I will if you give it that endorsement.
Yeah, we can do it.
I just want to go see the fist thing.
Oh, yeah. You want to see Joe Louis' fist?
Yeah.
I mean, it's lit. I got a lot of, like, connection to the city. Like, even, like, that's why I was offended that Trey Songz went to Detroit and acted a fool at Cobo Hall. Like, bro, like, chill. I mean, at the Joe Louis Arena. Like, this is legacy we talking about. Like, hey, you messing up the legacy here.
Right.
So, Lauren is flipped. 313. 713 back to 313.
So she's really a D-Town representative.
Listen, honestly, it's Motown and Mo City. That's where we at.
Okay.
To D-Town.
Detroit made me. Houston saved me.
Dallas paid me.
That's the motto right there. That used to be in my Instagram caption. You know, it used to be. Now I'm Huey Mix with O'Reilly.
That is what it says.
That's accurate.
Thursday, I'm trying to save the world. Friday, I hit the club. Shout out to Cole.
I like that.
So... we going to Detroit.
We going to Wings Day first.
Bangers and Brunch won't go to Detroit, but we'll come to Detroit.
Yeah, we might have to rebrand it. We can't call it Bangers because that might.
Yeah, you're going to bring the wrong side out.
It might get a little scary.
Who is it? Trick Trick?
Yeah.
Should I even not say his name?
don't know shit.
T Grizzly's the dude right now in Detroit. Yeah. First day out.
Shout out to Los. Los put me on that track.
I don't know shit about Detroit, bro.
Nah, that T Grizzly track
that
go
That T Grizzly song.
Shout out to Los. Every time go somewhere, Los be like, hey, tell Phife to play that T Grizzly. I'm like, bro, I can't make this man DJ this song.
But you know what? Like, I know the song, and I've been on the song since, like, December.
Right.
But when I'm like, oh, shout out to Detroit, it'll be like one or two people raise their hand. Yeah. And so, like, the song starts out so slow. It's kind of like the Meek Mill song. It starts out like a real long build-up.
Okay.
And he's telling his story about him getting out or whatever, him going to jail. And so you really got to be from Detroit to know about it.
Yeah.
Or whatever. So if I play it, I'm like, what is he playing? But then he turn up.
Yeah. Man. But well, I'm going to listen to it in the car.
You didn't hear when it got played at Trappies?
No.
You was probably outside talking or something,
if you
man.
Come in a quill, I'll play it today in quill.
Say less.
Los rapped it word for word, bro.
Yeah, listen.
Yo, I played it in Canada for Black Ski Weekend up in Canada.
Okay.
Man. The promoter's like, yo, cut it off. Cut it off. Yeah. They take their shirt off and just.
I got to hear it, bro. I'm like, all of y'all are giving the same endorsement.
It's on that level, dog.
But I need to hear it. Read the lyrics first and then play it. No. Okay. Because he's telling the story and you want to know what's going on, but then you'll be like, oh, I got it.
So that's why the street niggas turn up right here.
Yeah. Right. For real.
Yeah.
It's like Set It Off, Lil Boosie.
Okay. Is he an underground artist?
He was, I don't really know his full story, but I know he got arrested in, was college? Like, he had a scholarship and he got arrested or something like
Somebody
that.
Somebody snitched on him on campus. Yeah.
Okay.
I think it was over a female or something like that. But I think we're getting to the closing portion of the show.
Yeah, before we close, though.
Go ahead.
I got a shout out to my boy, T.Y.E.
Yeah.
I thought it would drop March 16th, but it ended up coming out last night. At 4:30 a.m., but TR32, Empty the Clip dropped today. I'm proud of y'all boys. 32 Lifestyle, Keenan, TYE. I'm happy.
I jammed it all the way here.
Yeah, and that's a powerful record. You know what I'm saying? So
yeah, I'm proud of them, man.
Yeah.
Phife, where can we find you? Social media.
Social media, the real DJ Phife on Twitter. I'm still on Twitter. Twitter
we,
and Instagram.
We still on Twitter.
Yeah.
Gotcha. DJ Phife on Snapchat, and you can Google me. Just
okay, DJ don't talk your shit.
You can Google me DJ Google Phife me, and it's going to pull up. Yeah. So you can find me on iTunes. Just Google DJ Phife. Turn it. It's there. Go download it. Stream 99 cents.
Yeah.
It's on Spotify. I got a Spotify playlist that's popping real hard. Yeah. So, yeah.
It's real.
It's there.
100%.
That's what's up. You good?
I'm great.
We got to move on to the announcements portion of,
of
the evening.
We do got to do that.
So she's not good.
Let Pastor Kenny take it off.
All right. You know what I'm saying? Back to it. I'm going to tell y'all every time, y'all hear the sound of my voice, please pull up. Hip Hop Book Club, March 20th, Josie Records from 7 to 8:30. We not reading books, but we're going to go over Kendrick Lamar's Good Kid, Mad City. That's how we consume hip hop.
Yeah.
Go ahead, I'm gonna let you do bangers.
April 1st.
Yeah.
April Fool's Day.
Damn fool.
We trying to make it a damn fool.
Yeah.
At the Loft at Gilly's. Tickets are on sale now. They going fast. Get your tickets at www.goodculture.life. Bangers and Brunch. It's an art show. It's a party. It's an experience. It's a whole fucking put on for Dallas that you need to be a part of. If you love yourself and you love your friends and you love this city, and you love to fucking eat and drink, you need to be there.
Yeah. And we taking it elsewhere. So, Dallas, pull up.
Yeah.
Because we going places.
We going places, man.
Yeah.
Like, this shit really taking off like a rocket, and I ain't ashamed of it. This, y'all joke about 2017, T. Lee. This is 2017 good culture, man.
Say less. Yeah.
He got all super deep. I mean, those was my announcements. Come fuck with me and Phife at Quill.
Straight like that.
Y'all know where we at. Yeah. So, Wednesday, Quill, come through. Turn
Well, shit. That's it. It's the Good Culture Podcast.
Good Culture Podcast. Let's go.
Yeah.
Yeah.